Welcome tonight to Atlanta Live. I am Pastor E. John Citizen and my wife, Nikita Citizen. We are the pastors of Spirit Life Church of God in Powder Springs, Georgia. All Atlanta Live viewers tonight, I want to welcome you to the set. We're going to have a great time tonight. We have powerful guests, wonderful discussion. We have a fun guest tonight, Miss Pickles. You're going to really enjoy her. Now, Nikita, I understand you have a scripture tonight to open us up with.
First Peter.
Second Timothy
1:7. For God did not give us the spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. God wants us to walk in His will and in His power and in His authority.
Amen. And that's what we want tonight. We want the authority of God to pour out in this place tonight. The manifestation of God's grace and mercy will be poured out. So I want you to gather the family around the television, get on the website tonight, view the set tonight, what's going on. Dial the number at the bottom of your screen, 770-300-9828. It's going to be your connection to God. There's prayer partners on the other end of that phone that wants to pray with you and bless you. So I'm asking you tonight, get the family, gather around the set. We're going to have a fun time tonight. We're going to have great music guests tonight. I'm telling you guys, if you hear the warm-up that I heard tonight, you're going to be blessed with the music. And it's a lot going to happen tonight if you allow God to speak to you, you'll hear His voice. If you allow God's power to manifest itself in your life, you'll receive His grace and His mercy. So tonight, I want you to gather around the set. Don't be afraid to dial that number, 770-300-9828. Our prayer partners want to pray with you. They want to bless you tonight. And I'm telling you, we're going to go to the music set with Bethlehem Church Praise. This is an amazing grace.
The King who conquered the grave, and worthy is the
Wow, what awesome worship by Bethlehem Church Praise Team. It's an awesome music set tonight here at Atlanta Live. You're going to be blessed all through the evening. They're going to be with us all night long. But we're going to have with us tonight Evangelist Shonda Norman. We're going to have Miss Tiffany Morrell. They've been working on this tour. You're going to hear more about that when they come onto the set. And I understand we have a special guest, honey.
Miss Pickles. You all are going to be blessed with Miss Pickles as well.
You saw how colorful she was?
Yes, amazing.
She seems like she's a lot of fun, a lot of excitement. She brings a lot of high energy. We're going to be having a great night. And we're going to go back to the music set with Bethlehem Church Praise Team. Our great God.
I see your majesty. Your glory shines for all the world to see. Look at the cross, I see salvation rise. Your voice like thunder calls the dead to life.
Praise team. anything good can come out of Bethlehem. You just heard it tonight. The Bethlehem Church Praise Team, I know their pastor is very proud of them and what they do for that local church. But tonight here at Atlanta Live, we have on the set Evangelist Shonda Norman. Welcome to the Atlanta Live.
Thank you.
And we have Ms. Tiffany Morrell.
Hi.
Welcome to Atlanta Live. It's good to have both you ladies. Now, I understand y'all in a tour right now.
Yes.
Have a big tour going on. Now, give me the name of the tour.
It's called Loving the Skin I'm In Conference Tour.
Loving the Skin I'm In Conference Tour.
Yes.
Honey, I think we have to get a part of that.
Yes, I love that. It's nice to be comfortable in your own skin.
Yes, it is.
That's
it
what
is.
God requires.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Now, you two ladies work together in this tour.
Yes.
Y'all partners in this tour, and I'm looking at y'all, and I can see something beautiful taking place with this relationship. Now, tell me a little bit about how you ladies met. How did this tour come together?
Okay.
And particularly your role in the tour.
Okay. Actually, I met Tiffany here when I was doing an event in Atlanta, a vision board event, and she was actually one of my vendors. And so during the break time of my event, what I did was ask Tiffany, I said, do you want 3 minutes to come up and speak about your business? And she took the opportunity, and when she came up, she spoke, and she blew us all away, and I was like, I need her for my next event.
God makes room for your gift. God will make room for your gift.
Yes.
Now, Evangelist Shonda Norman, you saw something.
Yes.
You heard something.
Yes.
You felt something.
Mm-hmm.
And God brought y'all together.
Yes, he did.
And now tell me, this tour, what's the meat of it?
Okay, with the Loving the Skin I'm In tour, basically is empowering women and young women.
Okay.
And what we do is we want to encourage those women who have very low self-esteem, who feel like, you know, I'm struggling in this area with trying to get my business together, or they're struggling with the way they look on the outside. And we know that beauty comes from the inside.
Yes.
But you actually need someone to pull that out of you. And so if you don't have someone there that's rooting you on and encourage you and telling you that just because you have nappy hair and your hair is not straight, you're still beautiful. Just because you're overweight and you're not slim, you're still beautiful.
Yes.
Because to be honest, slim people have a problem too. I used to have a problem with my insecurities because I was so skinny and I wanted to be big. And everybody was like, you don't want to be big. And I was like, y'all just don't know. Being skinny is tough, you know? So I just want to come in and empower women and young women. You are beautiful in spite of what you look like, in spite of what anybody else think of you. I mean, you're still beautiful.
Amen.
So that's what the tour is really about.
Well, you know, so loving the skin you're in.
Mm-hmm.
I like that. And the thing is, you're talking about a wide range of age groups.
Right.
From young women.
Right.
What you say, elementary or fifth, sixth graders?
Actually.
Young women, you start to mold them real quick.
Oh, yeah. We want to catch them at a very young age.
Yes.
Me and Tiffany were just talking about is putting together an additional tour after this tour just for our young people. Because I had parents contacting me regarding their 12-year-olds and 16-year-olds that they're dealing with this going through school now. You know, being picked on, being bullied. And it's like, we need to do something for our young people. Loving the Skin I'm In for them and let them know that, look, you're beautiful in spite of. And we want to be very transparent with our young people.
Wow.
So we have a story. Don't look just because you see us now, but this is what God has brought us to now. I mean, we were messed up in the beginning. I mean, Lord, I tell you, we were something rough in the beginning. But look at us now.
This is teaching them to just really know who they are at a young age.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, the tour is focused more on adult women right now, or you're talking about the whole family?
Right now, I want to reach the whole family.
Okay.
I want to reach everybody because it's just not one particular person. We even want to reach the guys as well.
Okay.
Well, eventually down the line, we want to bring in a young guy to actually mentor to the guys and let them know, look, there's other things to life than the negative things that you're doing, mm-hmm. you know. And I think that kids get steered the wrong way because they feel like people don't love them.
Mm-hmm.
And then if they've never been loved, then they don't know how to love themselves.
Yes.
So we got people coming in and like, look, I'm going to love you in spite of what it is. Let me love you from the inside out.
Amen.
Yes. because it's something about knowing who you are in Christ Jesus, because once you know who you are, mm-hmm. you can really conquer this world.
Yes. Right, absolutely.
Amen. And another thing, too, just being a part of the tour, like myself being an industrial engineer, the focus that I want to bring is kind of helping the young ladies and the older ladies know that whatever that goal is that you have in life to achieve, like achieve it.
Yes.
Make that vision board and bring those goals and dreams into mm-hmm. fruition. Because growing up, it's like, you know, everyone always said, like, you know, you can't be an engineer. Like, you don't look like an engineer. And I'm like, well, what does an engineer look like? Exactly. So I just want to show that, you know, whatever it is that you want to do, do it. Whether it's be an engineer, whether it's be a doctor, whether it's be a lawyer, whether it is to have your own business, because I also have my own business as well. Do it. Draw that vision out mm-hmm. and just be inspired to do it.
Amen.
And we want to motivate them.
The question I have is, now, what is your purpose in the tour? Well, how do you connect with the tour? Tell me a little bit about your part in this.
For me, I connect with the tour, like I said, just being an engineer and just showing the children and as well as the young adults that whatever it is you can do, despite of the negativities that are going on around you, whether you're being bullied, that, okay, well, you know, for me, it's like everyone kept saying, well, engineer is like something a man is supposed to do, or you don't, like I said, you don't look like an engineer. Mm-hmm. But I want to show them that despite of those negativities that you hear in your
yes.
ear,
mm-hmm.
that you can do that. You can do whatever it is that God has put on your heart to do. And mm-hmm. as long as, like, he's leading the way and all
Amen.
That you have
mm-hmm.
to do is follow. So what I bring is, you know, I listen to the scripture or read the scripture for Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ
mm-hmm.
who strengthens me.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I live by every day. And so
mm-hmm.
I want to encourage young women, you know, and also young men that live by that scripture every day and don't let nobody tell you no, that you cannot do anything that you want to do.
It's something about when you get a word and you mm-hmm. hold on to it.
Yes.
But it's holding on to it is the hardest part mm-hmm. for a lot of us. But so you all are teaching them how to hold on to that word and that you
it.
Can do all things through Christ
yes.
who strengthens
mm-hmm.
you.
Yes.
Now, it sounds
yeah.
like you ladies been down a journey. You've been down a path.
Yes.
Now, Evangelist Norman, where you come from? Tell me a little bit of your history. Who, let the viewers know who you are.
Okay.
What inspired you to create this mm-hmm. tour? Mm-hmm. And, you know, talk about your ministry. What is your ministry title? Tell me a little bit about your ministry. Mm-hmm. And then back us into, you know, what was the history behind
okay.
Evangelist Shonda Norman?
Who All right. are? My ministry is actually called Inspired Ministries.
Okay.
And our motto is believe it, receive it, and achieve it.
Believe it,
receive it, and achieve
Amen.
It. Because you got to first believe it, receive it in your spirit, and then you go out there and achieve it.
I love that.
And so how my ministry came about is I came from a background of abuse. And
okay.
I was actually sexually abused by my stepfather. And I was sexually abused from the time from 7 all the way up to the age 13. So I didn't have anybody to really talk to around that time, or nobody to relate to, or anybody that been through what I've been through. So I dealt with a lot of issues as I got older in life, and I thought that those issues wouldn't bother me in my adult years, but come to find out they did, which led me to trying to commit suicide 4 times. And
wow.
I think the last time, well, the very first time, I tried to hang myself, and the rope popped. And I think the second time, I took an overdose. And when I took an overdose, they admitted me into a psychiatric ward. And I told them, I said, you know what? I said, I'm fine. I'm perfectly fine. They were like, no, you're not. It was like, what's going on? I said, nothing. I got this. I'm fine. But really deep down inside, I wasn't fine because I felt like no one loved me. I didn't love myself. Mm-hmm. No one was there for me. You know, I had to look out for myself. So as I got older, I began to, in my adult years, begin to have nervous breakdown, mental breakdowns. And I remember having a breakdown in the house. And I cried out to God, and I cried.